welcome to Beautiful Snow TV, and welcome back, Snowflakes, and welcome if you are new. Make sure you guys hit that subscribe button, and don't forget to hit the bell notification so you don't miss another time when I upload. So here are all the products we're going to be using today. So I did not use the glitter, and I didn't use the yellow clay to make a bee. I felt the stress of drawing Mrs. Pooh Bear, you know, just a little bit too much, and it was getting really, really late, so I wanted to kind of hurry up and finish the set. So all these products will always be down linked down below, and also in my Amazon storefront. So I'm also going to be trying out these I think they're called sanding disc, and I got this off of Amazon, so I'll be trying it out as well. And I wanted to try these. Look at the comparison to how big it is compared to the ones I got from Shein. And I really am glad that I bought these. This is such a deal breaker when filing the edge of the nail, the free edge. And we're going to go ahead and get started with the polygel application. So here we have our More Van polygel. I really love this color. I'm going to buy this again. And this is also close to another color that I posted on my Instagram. About a few minutes ago of a client's nails that I did. This one was a little bit more translucent though, but it was still kind of the same color, but I really, really like it. Morphe got some really nice variety of colors for polygel, and I really, really like that about their brand, especially like for, you know, because people say that, you know, polygel doesn't have that many colors and, you know, can't really do too many designs. If you really look, they have them. So I'm just going to go ahead and show you guys my application here on the thumb. Since all the nails are the same shape, a taper square here, I'm just going to kind of go in and do that, show you guys the application on the thumb. As you see, I go in with a big bead. This polygel was a little bit warmer than normal. I'm going to get a mini fridge to put them in. I heard that was a really, really great hack to keep your polygel a little bit more stiffer and more manageable as well. So I might buy that, you know, sometime here in the near future and show you guys and let you know how it's, you know, that particular hack is working out. But yes, I'm just gonna kind of show you guys the application process, and I'm just gonna go in with my brush. Once you see the polygel kind of self-level, as you see it doing here, it's not so lumpy from where you've touched it, that means you're ready for your brush application. So as you can see, nice and smooth, and then I'm just gonna go over the cuticle, and then I'll cure for a full 60 seconds. And here is the application all done. Don't worry about the thumb. I'm gonna go ahead and file that down. So I'm gonna take this application, looking really, really good on that taper square. I'm just gonna go ahead and take this, I think that's an 80 grit, the purple. It was way too rough. It had never been used before, so it was way too rough. I did go ahead and change it out for I think it's a 150 grit. That was way better. It's still almost as rough, but not much. But I'm just gonna go ahead and go over the entire nail with the sanding band. I do this just to even out the nail, so I don't have to do a whole lot of filing with my hand file. Excuse me. I do this with the e-file, so I don't have to do a whole lot of hand filing and, you know, hurt myself or just really tire myself out. So I do that step first just to kind of debulk the nail a little bit as well. Now some people use a ceramic band, but I feel like my sanding band gives me a little bit more control. And I feel like I, you know, kind of have more hands on the reins with that one. So I'm just gonna go ahead and go over all of the nails, and then I'll go ahead and do my cuticle, and then I'll do my hand filing after that. You guys can just kind of watch this process. It is usually the same process. And make sure you guys follow me on Instagram. make sure you guys follow me on TikTok. I post over there as well. Make sure you guys check out my description box and my Amazon storefront, guys. I have lots of goodies, lots of good products, very good prices, and I do earn a small commission when you do purchase through my Amazon storefront or through any descriptions, coupon codes or QRs or whatever they have me providing for you guys, any discounts or anything like that, or any product reviews. So it helps out the channel a lot, and I really do appreciate if you guys would go ahead and, you know, check that out. Even if you don't click on anything or even buy anything, checking me out does help as well with the algorithm, especially with YouTube. Make sure you guys hit the subscribe button, and yeah, you guys can kind of finish watching this process. Now this, guys, is a sanding, not a sanding bang. This is a 5-in-1 carbon bit. I love this bit. It is also a safety bit. Most of the safe bits that I use now, especially on clients or either myself, are safety bits. I have at least 20 bits that I use. Sometimes I do replace them, but I haven't used them enough to the point where I have to replace any of them at the moment. I'm just usually adding to my collection, but I also go over my 5-in-1 carbon bit with over the entire nail, and this is them all filed, shaped, and buffed. I did buff them off camera as well, so I'm just gonna go ahead and try to get right into the nail art. I have a small liner brush. I think that's a 9mm, 8mm, something like that. I wrote them on there, but I used the brushes so much it kind of wiped off. So I believe I posted these in my Amazon storefront as well, the liner brushes that I use. So I'm just gonna go ahead and kind of put a matte top coat, I believe, on here. I was gonna go straight in, and that was my mistake. I went straight in with polish. I've learned a little trick. Use matte top coat or base coat. As you can see, I did wipe it off, and we're gonna go ahead with some matte top coat. We're just gonna do a thin layer. You don't wanna try to coat it, you know, for real. You're just doing this for nail art purposes. It just kind of gives a smoother surface to work with, and that's just my experience and my little hack that I've learned, you know, just by playing around with nails and stuff like that and doing small, you know, practice nails and stuff like that. So I'm gonna go ahead and just put a thin layer, cure that for 60 seconds, and then we'll get right into the nail art. And here I pulled out my airbrush machine. I don't know why I try to use the ombre brush. It just, I don't know. I guess I need the trick for that. I feel like the brush has to be like dry, but I don't know. If you're working with gel polish, it's not gonna be dry. I don't know how to explain it, but it never works for me. So I just pulled out my airbrush machine for a flawless airbrush ombre look. I'm just gonna go ahead and put some of that yellow. I feel like it's a golden yellow. I really would name, if I had a nail polish collection or gel polish collection, I would name this Pooh Bear. Like, it is so, its color. So I was really loving it. It's like a honey gold yellow. It's like really, really pretty. Just a few drops of acetone. Not that much acetone, not that much, guys. So I, you know, disclaimer, I do not believe in, you know, not using the airbrush because of its harmful chemicals. Look, we work with nail supplies. It's a luxury. It's not a necessity. So I did go ahead and airbrush my thumb there, and I really love the way it was coming out. And then I'll also go ahead and airbrush my pinky as well. Then go ahead and cure those. Now I'm going to go in with the black. Just put a little dollop there. I don't really need a whole lot on my palette. And I'm just going to go in for my little beeline, my little honeybee. Now, this is one of my first nail arts. I am going to try and get a whole lot better with my control and my line work. I am, you know, still a novice when it comes to artwork, but actually doing my nails, yes, I can do them. But like I said, you guys are on this journey with me. I wipe off a lot because if I don't think it looks right and I think people will make fun of it, you know, even though in the nail industry, we just, you know, keep trying. But I have seen some horrible artwork and they have put this on clients, and I just feel like if I wouldn't put it on myself, I wouldn't put it on anybody else. So I really try to strive for perfection. I am perfectionist in some way. Yes, I'm still learning, but I really push myself, try to be hard on myself to really learn and just really push myself to the artist that I know I can be. I used to be in art class back when I was in high school, even went to the rodeo with the art for Houston. That's really, really big. And I even had Starbucks, one of the local Starbucks, buy a piece of my art. So I know I can draw. It's just the tiny canvases are just so crazy. So I liked it, that placement, and I wanted it to kind of flow into the next nail where the B is going to be. So I just kind of curved it around, and this right here is very simple. You just have to have more control of what, you know, how long or short your little lines are. So right here, I think I'm going to go ahead and cure this, and then I'll kind of connect it to the middle finger there. So I'm just going to kind of keep those together. And then once I'm done with that, I'll go ahead and cure for a full 60 seconds as well. Now I'm gonna go ahead and draw my B. This was slightly difficult because I didn't really know where to start. I was thinking of that movie, the B movie, and in my head I was trying to like draw him. Oh wait, y'all look at me, don't remember how I did these nails. So I am actually gonna start with Pooh Bear. I thought the B could be last, I think, because if I look back over, this is almost 2 weeks ago, when I look back and I was doing this design, I kind of wanted to get Pooh Bear out the way because I knew it was going to take me the longest. So I just took a dotting tool, just kind of made like the shape of his head, well, her head, and I just kind of rounded it out a little bit. I feel like I should have made it bigger, but I feel like this was really, really cute, especially if the nails would have been slightly shorter. But I don't know about short nails, y'all. I love them. I just think certain designs don't look good as short nails, and I feel like this one may have looked a little bit better if it was a shorter nail. I don't know. Next time, we'll see. So I'm taking my dotting tool again, just kind of rounding out the ears. When doing nail art, sometimes gel polish can be a little bit runny. Try holding your hand, you know, straight down, because it was trying to like run toward like the edge of the nail, and I had to like keep fixing it because I wanted to be very pigmented. You know, this yellow is very pigmented. I wanted it to be that way, so I had to kind of like catch it, I guess, like chase after it. I don't know if it was a brand or the way I was holding my hand. So I did go ahead and get that Pooh Bear outline So I'm going to start with the eyes. Now, y'all, I'm going to say sorry for, you know, the next 3 minutes. I am slightly out of frame on some things, so I'll be trying to explain it best I can. I just took the dotting tool and just made like a little half circle for the nose. It's very, very self-explanatory. Did just some like ovals for the eyes. They became ovals. Don't worry about what they look like right now. They became ovals. Why you look mad right there? So I'm just going to take my liner brush and just kind of go in. I could not get the middle of the Pooh Bear to save my life. It was too thick. It was not a thin line, y'all. I had to wipe all of Pooh Bear's eyeballs off. It was, I don't know, I was getting frustrated because it wasn't coming out the way I wanted. Look at that. So I just went ahead and wiped Pooh Bear eye off. Like, just get out of here. So I started over with the eye and I said, let me go ahead and cure that because if I don't, I'm going to mess it up. So I'm going to go ahead and take my black liner brush. And y'all, I'm so sorry about being out of frame slightly, but I just took like a little bit of white and did the nose, and then I did the rest of this off camera, guys. It just wasn't coming together on camera. It was taking me so long. I do apologize, but it's very simple. On the next one, I got you guys. I'm so sorry. So I'm just gonna take this clear yellow. I think it's called Garden something from Born Pretty. It's one of their clear jelly collections. It's like a yellow and it really resembles honey. And I really, really like that. So I'm gonna do some honey drips. Y'all, this stuff was lucrative, liquefied. Do you hear me? Like, I didn't mean to say lucrative, but it was liquefied. Like, it was running. Like, it acted like honey. It was running all over the place. I had to keep wiping. But look at the glare on that. Like, you really would think it's honey drip. Like, it is so, so nice. So I just had to work fast. and just try to make my honey drips as neat as it could be. And then I cure for 60 seconds. And if you have not already noticed, you're more than halfway through this video. So make sure you hit the subscribe button and support your girl for free. And here is the honey drip. So now we're gonna work on the B. I was gonna use some rhinestones for the B, like as the body, but then I was like, nah, cause you gotta have the black lines on there. So I'm just going to take a dotting tool and make like a little oval kind of shape. I should have made him bigger, but I didn't. And I just went ahead and cured that really quick. And then I'm just gonna take my small liner brush and paint like the little, you know, black lines on the bee. This is pretty self-explanatory, so I'll let you guys watch this process. After each step, I did cure for like 10 or 15 seconds. So here is how it is looking. I didn't want to add anything else to this nail. To these nails, I just wanted it to be just like that. So I'm going to go ahead and take my top coat and I'm just going to put a shiny top coat and be done with them. I really didn't want to mess them up by adding any rhinestones, or this is more of like a simple kind of nail art thing that I saw and I really wanted to try for you guys, just to kind of show it can be done even by a beginner. I feel like I'm intermediate, but on a nail art, yeah, look at that shine. Pooh Bear is, she is diva. She's rocking out. So I'm gonna go ahead and put some cuticle oil just to nourish back my cuticles from all the beating they took with all the alcohol, acetone, and things like that. I'm just gonna go ahead and go over my cuticles with this, and I think that one was running out, almost out. But make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe. Let me know what, in the comments, what you guys think about this set. I feel like it was pretty simple, pretty straightforward. I'm just gonna let you guys kind of watch the play out of the final shots. And thank you so much for watching, guys. It was such a pleasure as always. I love communicating with our community, and I'll see you guys in the next one.